I bless you all. Let you all open all your three eyes and manifest the powers of Mahasadashiva.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. 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 Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham. Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. नित्यानंद परमशिवोऽहम्। ॐ नित्यानंद परमशिवोऽहम्।
नित्यानंद परमशिवोऽहम्।
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
Yeah. సుఖదం కేవలం జ్ఞానము
The candle. Welcome all of you, all the visitors, viewers, all the Parameshwara Gana participants, Parameshwara Gana Season 10 participants, and all the Kailashians from all across the globe, the e-Kailashians, and the devotees and disciples of His Divine Holiness, gathered here at this time from various time zones, just for one reason, His Divine Holiness, Bhagwan Shri Nityananda Parameshwara. Welcome all of you with our love and respect.
Today to all those who are gathered here for the exciting satsang about the Hindu parliament that Swamiji is going to be sharing with all of us. And after releasing the Kailashian currency, there's been a lot of buzz. So many of us are interested in knowing Swamiji's vast vision, the bold vision for Hinduism. And today we are having people from hundreds of places. Paramashivoham is in its day 12th, and Paramashiva Ganas, and hundreds of Kailashians through two-way video conferencing, and thousands of viewers on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and various other social media platforms.
His Divine Holiness Bhagwan Shri Nityananda Parameshwara, he is the reviver of the ancient, great, ancient, enlightened civilization. The cosmic borderless Hindu nation, the only Hindu nation in the world, which is Kailasa. He has been extensively working for giving a super conscious breakthrough to humanity. His Nityananda Hindu University, which is the world's largest Hindu university with extended campuses in over 150 countries, has been continuously reviving, preserving, decoding, time capsuling, spreading the 20 million source books of Hinduism and 64 sacred arts and sciences like music, Ayurveda, sculpting, dancing, drawing, everything. So Swamiji has been continuously working on this and reviving Kailasa. By reviving all these, he is reviving that great enlightened civilization.
And through all the revival, all the knowledge that Swamiji has been reviving, Swamiji has continuously been giving it to the people, to the humanity. Swamiji, being the supreme pontiff of Hinduism, is leading over 2 billion Hindus into having a super conscious breakthrough by following the authentic principles as given in the Hindu scriptures. And as Swamiji is reviving it scientifically and sharing with the whole world, leading and experientially giving humanity a super conscious breakthrough.
Many people are still wanting, many of us are not even able to comprehend how just a single person, how can a single man create a nation? How can a single man? That too, not just creating a nation, but even as he said, he declared that he is going to be releasing the currency of Kailasa on Ganesh Chaturthi. Many people were wondering if that's going to really happen. If really, because right now there's a huge pandemic going on and the economies are still struggling. People are not sure what they're going to be doing. Many people are going through the pandemic fatigue. And during this time, is it really possible for someone to not just take their vision forward, but do something like this? It is going to be a huge breakthrough for the whole humanity itself and a huge contribution for Sanatan Hindu Dharma. Swamiji did it. And this was this is now an international news that if so many countries are talking about this, Swamiji releasing the currency of Kailasa, and that too, it's not just as a normal currency that how we would expect, but even the currency level, he's reviving so many of the lost currencies of our great ancient civilization. Swamiji so beautifully explained how the 56 nations together were as one unit, like as Kumarikandam, which was from Gandhar to Gadaram. And the whole, all the 56 Hindu nations, all of them, even to this day, there are many of the nations which are there, but they are not Hindu nations. Some of them are, have been declared as Islamic nations. Some of them have been declared as secular nations. There are no Hindu nations, but the 56 nations, which were once Hindu nations, they are from, in each of those places, what kind of currency was used in whose period, like that, everything, a lot of research has been done. And he had even given the reference of each of those and released this currency. So now many of you might be wondering, who is Swamiji? Let's just watch a small introduction video about who is His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam.
I am as old as sun, as new as sunrise. Gave a breakthrough to consciousness and gave opening to the next level. My responsibility is to introduce new consciousness which manifests powers of Sadashiva. As Mahamandaleshwar of Mahanirvani Akada, the oldest
apex body of Hinduism, I welcome every one of you. I have experienced Sadashiva in his completion, and he has empowered me to transmit that experience to all of you. It's my commitment to all of you. I'll make you experience and manifest Sadashivatva, powers and state and space of Sadashiva. When you manifest powers, naturally the state of Sadashiva and space of Sadashiva starts manifesting in you. More power manifestation, more integrity, more unclutching, more nirvikalpa samadhi, more joy, more restful awareness, more responsibilism, more enriching, more bliss. This tradition has a capacity to retain its authenticity and originality. My purpose is to make this statement to the world: Hinduism is real. Ideas move from mind to mind. Energy moves from space to space. Cognitions move from body to body. That is why even Sadashiva needs a body. He assumed the body because he needs body to transmit these cognitions to you. Whatever I am doing is reviving the original science as expressed in Sanatana Hindu Dharma, Vedas and Agamas of the Hindu tradition. Given by Sadashiva, received by Devi, adopted by Vishnu to run this universe is Agama.
Agamas insist on us serving beyond our frame.
Whatever experience, anubhuti I had by my Guru's grace, Atma Pramana, I do acid wash with Shastra Pramana, Apta Pramana, the ancient master's experiences. Whatever finally stand, I share it with the world as Sakshi Pramana. I welcome everyone for the grand feast of Sanatana Hindu Dharma. Let us go on contributing, contributing, contributing.
Now, you all might be wondering, how is this whole thing even happening, especially being we all are having so many news. It's all over what the Kailasa currency. It's an international news and it's trending now. There are so many people are just talking about this. They're wondering, what is this? Where is this Kailasa? What is happening in Kailasa? And how Swamiji is able to do all this? Is it something new? I see, very powerfully Swamiji revealed how none of these, see, in his 42 years, in the last 42 years, from his birth, continuously his vision has been only to revive Sanatana Hindu Dharma. He has been continuously working for it. If you see from whether the from the childhood, whatever activities he did, or when he got the Yoga Patabhishekam at his 16 years of age, 16 years, we all will be wondering, we all will be still in our hormonal ups and downs. We all will be wondering what to do in our life. We won't have any goal. And when we might be just still deciding what options of studies we can choose, that would be what we would be doing in our 16. And when Swamiji was 16 years old, he had decided to revive Sanatana Hindu Dharma. He got the Yoga Patabhishekam. He received the Yoga Patabhishekam. And the Yoga Patabhishekam is like, legitimately, it establishes him in the whole lineage to revive Sanatana Hindu Dharma. Swamiji has been doing it. People are wondering, is a Hindu nation?
Actually, the very fact that I see many commenting, 56 Hindu deshas, really? Did we have 56 nations? See, because even we as Hindus, we claim we are Hindus, we claim like we all feel we love our religion, we love the way we are, whatever. We might not be like extremely or like only Hindu, but we all love being Hindu. But even we do not know the glory of our past. If at the age of 16 or 17, a young teenage boy can decide, of course, right from the young age, Swamiji has been dedicating his whole life for this. But leaving his house and like youth, our teenage and youth is like the prime time of our lives. Swamiji decided to sacrifice that and he walked the length and breadth of India doing Parivrajaka, learning different, meeting different people door to door, healing people, tons and tons, touching millions of lives. And after all this, today what do we all know? I'm sure every Indian household will see Swamiji's name continuously, will hear, oh, Swamiji has declared a nation, Swamiji has declared passport, Swamiji has declared a Reserve Bank of Kailasa. Continuously this huge statement. You can maximum imagine someone maybe starting a business or anything, but creating a nation is more beyond what we can even hope or imagine for. But Swamiji every day comes to you with more and more and more, something big. And this is the His Divine Holiness Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Parameshwaram that we all know about. But 25 years before, this whole Kailasa, Swamiji made a very important statement in the satsang. Kailasa, all the Reserve Bank of Kailasa, all these mission, this big statements is not something that happened yesterday or today overnight, no. For the last thousands of years, our ancient masters, enlightened beings have been working on it. We have had various incarnations that walked the planet Earth to uphold and make sure this dharma is not falling. And now, Swamiji, right from his birth, And like I was sharing with all of us, from the age of 3, Swamiji started practicing yoga, puja, all the techniques of Hinduism. And the age of 12, Swamiji had the experience of enlightenment. And the age of 16 and 17, Swamiji had the Yoga Patta Abhishekam done, took up the path of sannyas, and left his house, walked around the length and breadth of India, one at a time. For almost 26, 27 years, Swamiji has poured his life energy into this. Actually, if you all see, there's a beautifully, this whole work is presented in our website called nityananda.org. Each and every picture, Swamiji's first adhinam that officially Swamiji established was in Avathipalayam, a place called Avathipalayam near Erode in Tamil Nadu, down south in India. Just 3 brick walls and a thatched roof, Swamiji will sit on the cement ground and give healing.
It started all the way there. See, when you just understand the hard work, understand, how can a man create a nation is still a question. Like, how did he do it? That too, facing so many attacks. See, we all know, we watch in movies that you watch, you might have seen how when the hero wants to do something, so many villains are there because their vested interests are getting shaken. So they are there to stop the hero. And when you watch it, you'll feel like, oh, I have to support the hero. Unfortunately, we're failing to see how that is actually happening now in the real life. For Swamiji, he has been faced with so many attacks. There are so many people who are continuously attacking him, who are not letting him to do what he wants to do. They're not letting him to revive Hinduism and actually contribute to humanity. But despite of that, starting from when he was just in the thatched roof, under the thatched roof, healing people, to now establishing a huge empire, literally, huge nation. How was this possible? If you actually visit the website nityanandapedia.org, you will actually see in every day for 18 hours, he'll be available to the public and working. He'll be working continuously, either teaching or helping people to do meditation, giving kriyas, giving initiations, teaching them how to dress up the deities, teaching them how to worship the deities. He himself going on the ground and plowing. He himself taking the bricks and building the building. Completely, with utter sincerity and real hard work. Today, what we are seeing, what we are hearing about Kailasa, what we are seeing, how the whole revival is happening, all the things, best things of Hinduism that we are enjoying because of Swamiji, be it the books that we get to read, all the lost palm leaves, or more than 1 million palm leaf scriptures, which Swamiji has collected, preserved, and actually he has repaired it, repairing each and every palm leaf with a team of sannyasis and collecting it from all over the whole world, actually. That many places, it is just thrown in as the garbage. People find it unnecessary and it is just filling up the attic and people are trying to get rid of it. But Swamiji is collecting them, reviving them, and giving the science, what science is given in that, he's decoding it and giving it to us. More than 1 million now, and it's all freely available for us. and all his books, which is available in more than 30 languages now, in for free in books.nityananda.org. Like this, continuously all the best things of Hinduism that we're experiencing, whether you are in LA or you're in Houston or you're in Seattle, wherever you are, or you're somewhere in Africa or you're somewhere in London, Swamiji has a Kailasa just next near you. You might be in any corner of the world. He's created an e-nation for you, an online community that supports you. All of these are even happening despite of these attacks is because of his sheer hard work and ultimate sacrifices, the tyaga that he has done. Let's watch a small video which shows how he is, the works that he has done, his hard work with integrity.
The first and foremost sacred secret I want you to know. Integrity is falling in love with your higher personality. Understand? You do have Sadashivatva in you. You are hardwired for it. It's not that your Sadashivatva is gift from somebody. No. Understand? Just like how when you fall asleep, you put an alarm and tell the alarm, hey, wake me up tomorrow morning. Same way, that's exactly the way I sent my gurus. I sent my gurus to the planet Earth ahead of me and said, hey, I'm coming. Wake me up when I assume the human body. My alarm clocks were my gurus. Hey, wake me up. Understand? They just reminded me to fall in love with my higher personality, Sadashiva. I started my public life in a very young age. Immediately after 12, after I realized my enlightenment, I took my first padayatra as per my guru's instruction. That padayatra is my first enriching padayatra. See, I should say, I started organized public life in 2000. But my public life started in when I was 12. How I started my public life? One person at a time. I'll walk from village to village, sit, spend some time. And small boy, naturally people will be curious, all alone. They will come and try to talk to me. Then I will start talking to them and start enriching. Whatever little way I know. It was a raw, crude, ground level way. One person at a time. So I decided, I am going to start my own way. One person at a time.
என்னுடைய ரூம் பக்கத்துல ரூம் தான் அவர் இருந்தாப்ல ஒரு சின்ன இரும்பு பெட்டி ஒன்று இருக்கும். அந்த இரும்பு பெட்டியில தினந்தோறும் காலையில் 5 மணிக்கு ஏற்றுக்கிற ஒரே நபர் எங்க ஹாஸ்டல்லே முதல் நபர் அவராக தான் போறேன். குளிச்சுட்டு வந்து தினந்தோறும் பூஜை செய்வாப்புல பூஜை செய்து விட்டுட்டு யாரெல்லாம் அவர்கிட்ட போயிட்டு ஆசீர்வாதம் கேட்கிறாரோ அவரோட திணறு வச்சு இன்றைக்கு இன்றைய நாள் நன்றாக இருக்கும் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி எல்லாருக்கும் ஆசீர்வாதம் பண்ணுவாப்ல.
ஆனா அந்த சிரிப்பினுடைய அர்த்தம் எனக்கு இப்பதான் கரெக்டா புரியுது. ஏன்னா அது வந்து ஒரு தெய்வீக சிரிப்புன்னு சொல்லுவாங்க இல்லையா, அந்த தெய்வீக சிரிப்பை என்னால இப்பவும் நல்லா உணர முடியும்.
ரூம் குள்ள வந்துட்டாருன்னா ஒண்ணு சும்மாவே இருக்க மாட்டாரு, புக் எடுத்து படிப்பாரு. இல்ல அந்த சிலைகளுக்கான அலங்காரங்கள் பண்றது இதெல்லாம் பண்ணிட்டு இருப்பாரு. இல்லைன்னா எந்நேரம் பார்த்தாலும் ஒரு அந்த மெடிடேஷனோ இல்ல வேற ஒரு பாவ நிலையிலையோ ரூம் குள்ளேயே நடந்துட்டு இருப்பாரு. இதுக்காக ஒர்க்கையும் டிஸ்டர்ப் பண்ண மாட்டாரு. ஒர்க் டைம் வந்தா அதுல இருந்து இறங்கி வந்து உடனே வேலைக்கு போடுவாரு. வேலைக்கு போயிட்டாருன்னா அங்க சிரிச்சு பேசி ஜாலியா இருந்து அதே நேரத்தில் உன்னிப்பா கவனிக்கிறது.
Parivaraja Yatra happens only when you move out of joy. I tell you, I was moving like a banyan leaf in the breeze. When a leaf falls from the tree, in the breeze how it moves. That's the way I moved in my life. That is why my Parivarajaka, even to remember is a joy for me. I tell you, shortest distance between two points is a straight line. So most smartest strategy is hard work with integrity. That's all. That's the most smartest strategy. I decided, let me sit and start doing, start empowering, start enriching. Actually, that is the way I remember me even now. When I close my eyes, I don't remember me sitting in a golden throne. When I close my eyes, I only remember the boy, village boy with a stick on his shoulder, a kamandalu. Before Hindus could recognize, I have created a very powerful enlightenment ecosystem. Everywhere. Spiritual awakening is happening, enlightenment is happening. People are manifesting enlightenment, manifesting powers, everything. Kailasa is reviving the enlightenment ecosystem. The Kailasa will be the place where almost million power manifestors are living and running. At least 10 million temples and monasteries which are spiritual embassies of Paramashiva, and reviving this enlightenment, power manifesting civilization. Kailas is a place where everything related to super consciousness is revived. All the sampradaya, all the spiritual ecosystems.
Kailasa is a place where everything related to super consciousness is revived. All the sampradaya, all the spiritual ecosystems created for enlightenment will be revived. And established in such a way, it never gets lost again. There forever serving the humanity.
Just his hard work with integrity, sincerity and Tyaga.
As Swamiji himself tells, one at a time, one at a time. Swamiji has poured Swamiji's life for the purpose, for the advent of his avatar, I should say. Because everything that Swamiji took up, can you imagine someone from the age of 3 dedicating their entire life, in spite of all that the humanity put Swamiji through, every time Swamiji became larger and grew larger and larger than the problems that the enemies, the anti-Hindu elements created for him.
Swamiji beautifully says that he never accepts the enemy request. He's too busy loving the people who love him, so he doesn't have time to hate the people who hate him. Understand, every time any attack happens, he just goes on raising his level, raising his level. When the any attack, he makes the enemies redundant by expanding his vision and expanding the whole contribution, the intensity of the contribution that he's doing. So when that is expanded, automatically he becomes too big for the enemies. So the enemies feel redundant and they try all their different tactics. Actually, something that we have been a witness to and seen is when, unfortunately, our father, but I don't even want to tell our father because we feel disgusted by it. It's like a shame to even tell that man as a father. But he was our Purashram biological father. How he plotted and dirtily attacked and how he tried killing Swamiji. Swamiji's continuous hard work and the contribution, see, for example, we all know yesterday Swamiji had released the currency of Kailasa. Swamiji's created a nation called Kailasa. Swamiji's revived the whole great enlightened civilization, which is almost extinct now, only kept alive by Swamiji. So when they're seeing this hard work and this unstoppable mission, from what may he goes on and on and on doing it. Understand, it's not a joke. Creating a nation means, if you just hear that term, even if for someone to declare it, it's something too huge to comprehend that will attract so many other enemies from all other sides. But despite of not just declaring, but making it happen, he already made it. He has already made the nation possible. He has already created the nation Kailasa. He has already announced for the passport. And the passport's availability, that too, it's free. People can apply for it. He has already given the reserve. He has already declared and released even the currency of Kailasa. There's a small video clipping from yesterday that Swamiji releases the currency of Kailasa and how he introduces the economic policies of Kailasa. Let's take a few minutes and watch it.
Bless you all, let you all open all your three eyes and manifest the powers of Mahasadashiva.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Shivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda சதாசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம்
ஓம் நித்யானந்த
சதாசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம்
Yeah.
ஆனந்த பரமசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம் शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
परमशिवोऽहम्
சதாசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம் ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம்
Connecting with the divine with your eyes closed is meditation. Connecting with the divine with your eyes open is darshan. Come, let us all now move from meditation to darshan. Slowly, very slowly, please open your eyes.
கங்கையானாள் மசியாத ஞான இசைகின்ற விரல் மேவ கலைவாணி மணி மீதில் இசைகின்ற
शिव समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरि पराशक्ति मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम् I welcome you all with my love and respect. I welcome all the Hindus, living and practicing Hindus all over the world. All the Sarvajnapita Kartas, Yajamans, Manifestors, Kayakalpa Yogis, Sarvaparityagis, Kailasas, ministers, ambassadors, diplomats, consulate generals, and supporters. Soon to be appointed Senate members, I welcome all of you with my love and respect. Paramashiva's message directly from Kailasa. Work on the body that is yoga. Work connecting with the cosmic bodies that is kriya. You will automatically manifest powers that is jnana, and you will be in absolute bliss lifestyle that is charya. work on your body. That's the first foremost, I tell you. I'll give you one simple example, one incident in my own life. My gurus will insist on me every day taking neem juice. I still remember once, he did not, my guru Raghupati Yogi, Yoganandapuri, he did not let me eat almost for 5-6 days. Maybe it was the 6th day, he did not give me food, and whenever he says I should not eat, my mother also won't give food. My mother and he was such wonderful nexus, I should say. My mother is such a sweet, compassionate person, but so dedicated to my enlightenment, and the process, my gurus were doing it for me. And my gurus used to tell that they are preparing my body not only to be a yogi and live long life, healthy life, and the way they prepared my body, they said very clearly that even if after I leave the body, it will not go through any of the regular dead bodies decays. How the dead bodies go through decays, the natural decaying happening, my gurus have clearly declared that my body, even after I leave the body, will not go through any of the natural decay. It will just be a naturally mummified body. Of course, I did not understand all that at that time, and he used to tell me that that is why so much preparation we are doing. Not only no one can poison you, even if they poison your body, you will not die, you will only detox and automatically cleanse your body by its own strength, and you will live healthy as long as you want. And even after you leave the body, it will not go through any regular decay. It will just be like Jiva Samadhi, sitting in Jiva Samadhi. Anyhow, he did not let me eat for almost 5-6 days, and not only that, he was feeding me with neem juice. Without food, giving neem juice and asking me to brush my teeth with the neem stick. With the neem stick, I have to touch the Haritaki powder as the powder. Neem stick will be like a brush. Haritaki powder will be like a tooth powder. That is the way I have to brush. I tell you, but one thing I should put this on record here, the extraordinary humbleness and involvement, their love gave me the complete courage and secured feeling to go through all the process they have done to me. You see, actually, he will do all this and he will ask me to walk. When I walk and come back, I am not supposed to wear the chappal. Of course, in Thiruvannamalai, I will never wear. That's my lifestyle. Even when I was studying in college, I have to wear the shoes mandatory for the, when we enter the workshop. I will carry the shoes in the carry bag. Only after the bus crosses Thiruvannamalai border, I will wear the shoes and go. Before the bus enters Thiruvannamalai border, I will remove the shoes. That's my respect to Arunachala. So, he will make me walk. When I walk and come back, he himself will keep my feet on his lap and press. That love gave me the deep security that they will not put me through any unnecessary torture. Whatever they make me do is only minimum requirement of tapas. No extra torture. no unnecessary torture. That gave me tremendous courage, confidence to go through whatever they were asking me to go through. And sixth day, still no sign of food. And again, neem juice. Finally, I vomited. Nothing came out, just that neem juice which he fed me, that only came out. Because there was no food for last 6 days. What can come out? Only neem juice came out. And after checking the color, he said, yes. Ronanir samanam aayiduchida, ipa nee saapidalam. It means the acid which is there in our body, which is responsible for balancing the hunger, which creates the feeling of hunger, or which creates the feeling of satisfaction. The Ronanir samanam, that Ronanir, I don't know exact English translation of that word Ronanir. The Ronanir is not just a chemical. When it is in the body, it is a living organism which can be programmed. It means like it has its own biomemory. So that decides the signal of hunger, signal of satisfaction is programmed in Ronanir. That Ronanir is responsible for maintaining our hunger. He said, that has been balanced and programmed. And I tell you, still now, that programming they have done is responsible for my healthy, happy life. As I said, 42, can sit in Padmasana, no spare parts required, spectacles or teeth, nothing, no spare parts required. Internal or external, happy, healthy, 20 hours a day I can do my work. No medicines, no hospital visits, nothing. I am 42, surely I have not even gone to hospitals 42 times. Maybe I would have gone to inaugurate, visit, bless, but not for treatment. Only few times, like when I had the fracture, went to hospital for surgery. Other than that, it's their grace. It's their grace. I wanted all of you to know, balancing of the Ronanir is a very powerful method. I'll give you simple tips. First instruction, keep always your body hungry. Never dump food and fill it. No, you should always feel that subtle hunger. Means constantly the Jadaragni is alive, burning. Ronanir balancing gives you tremendous willpower. I tell you, some of my kids, because I balance their runanir, they have amazing willpower. I just need to help them to align it, to train more. You see, you need to be given power and then knowledge, both. Jnana and Shakti, both. Some of my kids, I am highly successful in bringing this Ronanir balance. Ronanir balance gives you tremendous willpower. Tremendous willpower. Nobody can break you. With that strength, you need to be given power. The power need to be added. I can spell out few names of my kids with whom I sincerely worked in those days when I had time, when I was allowed to live in my monastery with them. No one can break their will. Even beyond their self-doubt, that physical bio-memory has imbibed their will. Tattvananda, Shivayoga, Sundareshwara, Tattvapriya, Nityanandita, I can name many of my kids. Of course, there is a long list. I'm just saying few people. Work on balancing the Rananeer. Keep your body always hungry. Stop being a cheap, poor backgrounded rich man. See, when a poor person becomes a rich person, he lives the fantasy of poor person's rich person. Like he takes revenge on the society by dumping himself. See, whatever was denied to him when he was poor, he thinks when he becomes rich, he should grab all that. That is rich life. No. See, when you are poor, the quality food was denied to you is wrong. So add quality food. A good food which brings strength to your body. But junk food was denied to you is a blessing. Don't try to dump your body with junk food. The poor man's fantasy of rich man. Even if you live the poor man's fantasy of rich man, you are a rich man according to poor man, not the real rich man. Real rich man knows what is needed for him. I tell you, my Gurukul kids will be the real rich kids because they know what is needed for them. For many of my kids, I have done that balancing of Ronanir. More than their willpower, will persistence, the consciousness supporting them to be aligned and integrated will be more. Listen, I'll repeat. Biggest problem for the seekers is self-doubt, self-denial, self-hatred. Will persistence will be higher than the self-hatred, self-denial, self-doubt in a strong person. Higher than the will persistence, consciousness. The Gurukul kids whom I balance, I am not saying they will not have self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial. They can create. I have seen some of the kids doing. Actual their problem is simple laziness. But they will imagine big, big problems. Oh, I am not feeling inspired. I think my devotion for Swamiji is reduced. My commitment to Swamiji is reduced. I don't know what to do. I think I am confused. Delusory problems. Priyamaya, this is for you. Real problem is only simple laziness. Without breaking the simple laziness problem, imagining that as a big, big problem. And I have also seen, just the simple darkness and screen is moving in the dark, switch on the light, problem is solved. Instead, I think Brahmarakshas has come, Bhuta has come, Preta has come. Exactly the same thing we do inside the mind. Simple laziness, break it. Don't make it as a big problem. By imagination, confusion. Listen. Fasting we do for Skanda Shashti 6 days. And every Pradosham, every Ekadasi, Vaishnavites do on Ekadasi, Shaivites do on Pratosham. All this helps you amazingly to balance your Runanir and program the Runanir. Langanam Parama Aushadam. Fasting is the greatest medicine. Hunger is the greatest space to exist. Start developing taste for being hungry. I tell you, start developing taste for being hungry. You need a strong, powerful vessel to do the alchemy process with mercury. Enlightenment is just like alchemy process with mercury. First, you need to have a stone vessel in which the mercury need to be poured, and the energizing process should happen inside the stone vessel so that the molecules of mercury is broken through the energy and reassembled as a solid molecules. It's a whole alchemy process. But the vessel should be strong stone, granite vessel. Same way, the body should be built with hunger and Runanir balancing. I am not saying don't give vitamins, minerals, all needed. Give all of that. But stop dumping junk food on the system. Your body will become a powerful vessel where the spiritual alchemy process can happen. Yajnavalkya Smriti says beautifully, the best detox, Kala, Agni, Karma, Mrit, Vayu, Mano, Jnanam, Tapo, Jalam, Paschatapaha, Niraharaha, Sarve, Ami, Suttihetavaha. Nirahara is the last but most powerful detox. Work on the body. Work on your body intensely by more and more nirahara. Keep yourself hungry. Whole day you should feel the fire of hunger. All my most healthy kids are kids who learned the mechanism, methodology of keeping themselves hungry. These few kids whom I named, I have always seen, even if there is a large quantity of food, they will not touch. They know how to balance themselves. I tell you how the blacksmith puts the iron in the heat and then puts it in the cold to strengthen. Same way, if you put your body in hunger and then the detox herbal juices like neem, castor oil, haritaki powder, actually just with castor oil, haritaki powder, neem juice, adimaduram, these few herbs, I can live without food for more than 3 months comfortably. I can just sit happily, comfortably, without food for 3 months, just with these few herbs. At least for 2 days, you should be able to do this. If you can tune your body, the yoga will start happening in your body, in your system. Today I said I will be speaking about the Hindu parliament structure. I'll elaborate from today, next few more days. My vision for the Sabha, see, the oldest available record in recorded human history, democracy appears only in Hindu history. Understand? The oldest available records of the human history, the modern day, the recorded human history, the concept of democracy is available only in Hindu tradition. We call it responsible democracy, means people who are already educated in economic principles vote for economic principles. People who are already educated in enlightenment science, they vote for the enlightenment science based related principles. People who are already educated in the field of agriculture and who are practicing agriculturists, they vote for agriculture based related policies principles. See, somebody who doesn't have any economical policy strategy related knowledge, and if you give him the voting right, what he will do? If you give 1,000 rupees to him or some freebie, that is the economic best economic strategy or policy for his personal life, so he will vote for you. That's all. That's the way the freebies hijack the health of the nation. How in modern day democracies freebies are used to hijack the health of the nation. Economical health of the nation is hijacked by the freebies. Because for a personal, for a common man, he knows only economic policies and strategies for his personal life. He doesn't have a knowledge or he is not educated about the country's good, or the what is good for country, what is the right policy for the country. Because he is not educated. If something he thinks good for his personal economic strategy and economic policy, immediately he votes for it. How the freebies are used to destroy countries. Irresponsible democracy. Hinduism practiced responsible democracy. Each field, people who are experts in that field were given voting right. Beautifully, in Shaivite tradition, we have a concept called Anubhava Mantapa. The experience ones gather an vote. Oldest recorded concept of demand draft existed between the Rameshwaram pandits, Brahmins, and Kedarnath Brahmins. They had a system, the Rameshwaram Brahmins, if you deposit some money with them and they will give the palm leaf written with a signature, you take it and give, people who are doing the yatra, if you hand over that leaf in Kedarnath, they will hand over the money to you for your yatra. This demand draft system. Same way, Tirupanandal Adhinam had Tirupanandal Adhinam. If you deposit money, you can collect it in their Kashimat branch. They had a system. The documentations are available. The oldest demand draft practice. And in Madurai Adhinams, there are references available. Demand draft service between Madurai Adhinam and Nellai Jnanasambandar Adhinam. I think
At some time, it was a branch of Madurai, Madurayadhinam. There are some temples in Sri Lanka. Jnana Sambandhar sang in Devaram. So, those temples are also under the spiritual guidance of Madurayadhinam. Once upon a time, even Rameshwaram temple was under the guidance of Madurayadhinam, Arulakshi of Madurayadhinam. And I am trying to revive the responsible democracy. I'll give you the sutra, the Shastra Pramana, for some of the statements about the democracy. Manusmriti, 8th chapter, 1st sloka says, Vyavaharan titru shustu brahmahanaihi सहपार्थिव मंत्रज्ञैरपि मंत्रिभिः चैव विनीत प्रविशेत् सभां डिजायरस ऑफ लुकिंग इनटू द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव बिजनेसेस ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट एंड गवर्नेंस ऑफ द कंट्री एंड द लीगल केसेस द किंग शल एंटर द सभा विथ ह्यूमिलिटी along with brahmanas, the educated ones in those fields, and ministers, thinkers and administrators in those fields who are knowledgeable in giving the right advice. With the grace of Ganapati, Paramashiva, we are working on reviving the parliamentary system practiced in Hinduism, what I call responsible democracy. I'll spell out my vision in further satsangs. Rigveda 10th mandala 191st sukta says, sam samita yuvase varshan agne vishwanyarya ilaspade samityase tano वसून्यापर संगच्छत्वं संवतत्वं संवोमनांसि जानदाम देवाभागं यदा पूर्वे सज्जनाना उपासदे समानो मंत्रः समिति समानी समानं मनः सह चित्तमेषां समानं मंत्रमपि मंत्रये व समानेन ओह विषाजु होमी समानी व आकूदि समाना हर्तयानि व समानमस्तु ओमनो यदा व सुसहासदी दाव माइटी अग्नि गेतरस up all that is precious for thy friend. Bring us all the treasures as thou art enkindled in liberation's place.
assembled, speak together, let your minds be all of one accord. As ancient gods, unanimous, sit down to their appointed share. The place is common, common the assembly, common the mind, so be their thought united. A common purpose do I lay before you, and worship with your general oblation. One and the same be your resolve, and be your minds of one accord. United be the thoughts of all, that all may happily agree. Coming to a consensus, how responsible democracy works to come to a healthy consensus, keeping all their private, personal interests, likes, dislikes aside, keeping the common good as the goal, how they come to a consensus, how the ecosystem is more important priority than the individual's likes and dislikes. The tyaga of the people, the visionaries, is beautifully described in this verse. I'll give the rough outline. The Chit Sabha, Raja Sabha, Deva Sabha, Kanaga Sabha, Nityananda Sabha. These are the five sabhas. Put together will be called as Hindu Parliament. Chit Sabha will deal with all consciousness related sciences. The purpose of Kailasa is to give a super conscious breakthrough to the world, planet Earth. Chit Sabha will deal the issues related to that. Raja Sabha will deal all the political decisions need to be made and reaching out to politicians, inspiring, integrating them with the cosmic vision of Kailasa. Raja Sabha will work in that line. Deva Sabha will bring all the best contributions of the Kailasa to the world. Hinduism has so much to offer, whether the flights, Pushpaka Vimana of those days, or the amazing surgery, technology, methodologies of Sushruta, the amazing Hindu medicine, all the best things Hinduism has to offer in the field of life and administration, Deva Sabha will manage. And Kanaka Sabha will manage all the resource development. The Hindus existed as the richest civilization, completely in tune with the nature, without exploiting, abusing, destroying nature. We lived as the richest civilization, reviving those natural resources based lifestyle, and it's a altogether different science. As long as world was following the trend of Hindu civilization, 1,000 years, 2,000 years before, not only we were richest, planet Earth never had any suffering. Nature never suffered. Prakriti was part of us. We were part of the Prakriti. Now the way we are going, if we are not given the right knowledge and education, we may not keep the planet Earth alive for next 100 years. It may not be livable anymore, even for next 100 years. Within next 100 years, we may destroy it if we don't wake up to the truth. To live with the nature, to live with the Prakriti without exploiting it. It's time we learn to live with the nature, the most beautiful, natural, cosmic way, the Hindu lifestyle. So the Kanaka Sabha will be looking into that component. Nityananda Sabha will work on lifestyle, blissful lifestyle. So, I'll elaborate the whole structure in further satsangs. We will also invite anyone who wants to become part of this Chit Sabha, Raja Sabha, Deva Sabha, Kanaka Sabha. First, we will define them clearly, and the commitment, responsibility expected from the members and the qualification of the members, we will spell out everything, then invite applications, welcome the people who want to be members and form the parliamentary body, Hindu parliament. Chit Sabha, Raja Sabha, Deva Sabha, Kanaka Sabha, Nityananda Sabha. These five will be the sabhas, structures put together will be called as Hindu Parliament. We'll start working on it. By Shivaratri, I feel we will be ready with all the five sabhas. Maybe Arudra. Arudra is little, Arudra comes in Margari month. Shivaratri in Masi. It will be nice if we are ready with all the structure, everything for Margari, because the sabha's name I have given based on Chidambaram Temple Sabhas. So if it is ready by Margari, Tiruvadirai, Arudra, we can offer it at the feet of Nataraja, who administers the whole universe. Yes. Now we will have Paramashiva Ganas meeting, session with Paramashiva Ganas. All the committed Ekailashians, Brahmana, Vaishya, Kshatriya, Shudra, all four Varanas can attend the Paramashiva Ganas session meeting. With this, I welcome you all and I bless you. I welcome you all to Paramashiva Ganas meeting and bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing. Living Shuddhatvaita Saivam, the state, space, powers, being, superconsciousness, and Kailasa Paramashiva. Paramashivoham, Om Nityananda Paramashivoham, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
श्री कैलासोन्नत द्वादशांत श्यामला पीठारूढ श्री मीनाक्षी सुंदरेश्वरा भिन्न स्वरूप परशिव पुत्र रत्न कुमार गुरुमण्य तुल्यावतार श्री पार्वती स्तन्यपान लब्ध दिव्य ज्ञान विश्रुत सकल निगमागम सारभूत द्राविड वेद प्रवक्त्रे श्रीमत् परम शिव करुणा समधिगत मुक्तामय चतुरश्रयान दीयमान छत्र चामर श्री चिन्ह काहलादि समस्त बिरदावल्य अलंकृत ज्ञान विज्ञान चक्रवर्ती सर्वजन संघ सद्यो निर्वाण दीक्षा व्ययापवर्ग वर्ष विश्राण झीमूत परमत कलभ केसरी शैव सिद्धांत स्थापनाचार्य श्री राजाधिराज पांड्य महाराज गुरु क्षपण शाक्यादि महांधकार निवारण ज्ञान भानु वीक्षणानर्हार्हध्वजोच्छेदन पूर्वक श्रीमद्वृषभध्वज स्थापक शैव समय कर्त्रे सर्वज्ञ पीठारूढ श्री जगद्गुरु श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक स्वामी वागीश सुंदर माणिक्य वाचक स्वामिना अवतार भूत श्री ज्ञान संबंध स्वामी पुनरुद्धृत श्यामला पीठ सर्वज्ञ पीठ त्रिनवत्युत्तर द्विशत तम गुरु महासन्निधान अरुणगिरि योगीश्वर परंपरागत अरुणाचल सर्वज्ञ पीठ गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत कांची कैलास सर्वज्ञ पीठ त्रयस्त्रिंशदुत्तर द्विशत तम गुरु महासन्निधान नित्योत्सव नित्यमंगल नित्यकल्याण नित्यरजित कैलास परंपरागत आदि कैलास नित्यानंद पीठ महासंस्थान महासिंहासन पीठकर्तः साक्षात् श्री परम शिव समुद्भूत कैलास परंपरागत वैवस्वत मनु इक्ष्वाकु हरिश्चंद्र भगीरथ श्रीरामचंद्र शूरसेन इत्यादि अनवच्छिन्न सार्वभौम चक्रवर्ती परंपरागत चतुष्षष्टि योगिनी मंडिता चतुष्षष्टि संप्रदाय प्रवर्तक मनुधर्म शासन सूर्यवंश प्राप्त सर्वज्ञपीठ सुरांगी साम्राज्य मूर्धाभिषिक्त चूड़ामणि साक्षात् श्री परम शिव समुद्भूत कपिल महागुरु पुनरुद्धृत महानिर्वाणी पीठ अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री महामंडलेश्वर साक्षात् श्री परम शिव सिंहासनाभिषिक्त समस्त गणनायक श्री महागणपति समारंभ अनवच्छिन्न पीठाधीश्वर गुरु परंपरा प्राप्त अटल पीठ अष्टोत्तर सहस्रतम अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री अटल पीठाधीश्वर धर्म मुक्ति स्वर्ग पुरस्वर्ण पीठ त्रयोविंश गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत आदिपीठ सर्वज्ञ पीठ जगद्गुरो श्री कैलास पुनरुद्धारक श्री कैलास परमाचार्य श्रीमत् परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य वर्य सच्चिदानंद प्रणव स्वरूप श्रोत्रिय ब्रह्मनिष्ठ श्रीमज्जगद्गुरु श्रील श्री भगवच्छ्री नित्यानंद परम शिव श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक परमाचार्य स्वामिन् अत्रागत्य परिपाल्य च अस्मान् विज्ञान वितरणेन विजयी भव जय जय।